used to think this was the beginning of your story. Memory is a strange thing. It doesn't work like I thought it did.
Since we were kids, we've been learning about our surroundings and the world around us through the stories we've been told. Regardless of the medium, the storytellers have always tried to capture their audience's attention using many elements, like suspense and emotion, or through their narrative technique, with linear or non-linear storytelling. French filmmaker Jean-Luc Godard said, "A story should have a beginning, a middle, and an end, but not necessarily in that order." In a way, this quote presents the essence of what non-linear storytelling is about. It's considered an abstract way to tell a story where the tellers don't stick to the A to B to C approach, but jump forward and backwards as they tell the story, like Christopher Nolan's Memento, or use different time periods, parallel timelines, and flashbacks, a technique which was made famous by the TV show Lost.
And who brought us here, John? The island.
To understand it better, let's dig deeper into some examples and see how the authors or filmmakers pulled off their tricks to deliver their stories. We will start with the sci-fi movie Arrival, directed by Denis Villeneuve and with a screenplay by Eric Heisserer. The movie explores human behaviour, motivation, and fear of the unknown. As the movie starts, we're introduced to the character of linguist Dr. Louise Banks, played by Amy Adams, as she experiences the birth and death of her daughter.
But now I'm not so sure I believe in beginnings and endings. There are days that define your story beyond your life, like the day they arrived.
The movie continues with Louise as she witnesses the arrival of the aliens. Later on, Louise encounters the new species in an attempt to establish a connection.
Now that's a proper introduction.
As Louise analyzes the alien language and their non-linear way of thinking, she starts to have flashbacks of her daughter's life.
Well, your name is very special because it is a palindrome. It reads the same forward and backward.
Only later in the movie, as Louise is unraveling the alien language, we discover that the flashbacks were actually flash forwards of her life. Her daughter is yet to be born. If we go back to the opening scene of the film, we discover that the birth actually takes place at the end of the movie. This non-linear way of telling Louise's story allows the audience to establish a connection and develop compassion for the protagonist and speed up the pacing of the story, as it tricks us into thinking of Louise's character as a grieving mother.
The assembly of film and how it can be changed to create a different idea. Now we have a close-up, then we show what he sees. Let's assume he saw a woman holding a baby in her arms. Now we cut back to his reaction to what he sees, and he smiles. Now what is he as a character? He's a kindly man. He's sympathetic. Now, let's take the middle piece of film away, the woman with the child, but leave his two pieces of film as they were. Now we'll put in a piece of film of a girl in a bikini. He looks, girl in a bikini, he smiles. What is he now? The dirty old man. He's no longer the benign gentleman who loves babies. That's what film can do for you.
Another example is A Little Life, a highly celebrated novel written by author Haniya Yanagihara. The novel explores the lives of four classmates over the decades as they experience life changes, struggles, good and bad moments. As we are learning more about their daily lives, the author introduces flashbacks to their earlier days, their childhood and teenage years. This mode of storytelling allows the readers to create a deeper connection and understanding of those characters, especially of the main character of the book, Jude, as we are becoming increasingly intrigued by his character, his state of mind and behaviour. We are slowly being introduced to the trauma that he suffered as a child. This helps not only to understand him and build compassion, but also adds tension and suspense, and we keep wondering, what could possibly have happened?
I wanted the book to feel, to change form. So in the first section that you mentioned, it feels very much like a typical Bildungsroman of four college students moving to New York and after graduation and trying to make their way. And then it becomes something else. It becomes more of a character portrait. And then it becomes a mystery. My best friend called it an emotional thriller, and I think that's right. Mm-hmm. If you look at the structure and the pace of it, it does unfold very much as a traditional thriller might. And that is, in many ways, how we experience the lives of people we know. We think we know them, and then as we spend more and more time with them, we realize that we know them less and less and less.
Although non-linear storytelling is proven to be an effective way of conveying different elements and themes, it is not the easiest to grasp, and therefore the storytellers need to find subtle ways to guide their audience through the stories. Another technique is using different colour templates, like the movie Nocturnal Animals, where director Tom Ford wanted to deliver his take on life, people, and the disposable nature of society.
Carlos told me.
I'm surprised. I thought we were hiding it pretty well. Hutton would be very upset to find out anybody knew. He just hates not to win.
The narrative of Nocturnal Animals takes the audience through three stories. The director, Ford, stated that he wanted to make sure the audience were aware of the shifts between those three worlds, as each world has a certain signature colour scheme that corresponds to a certain story and differentiates it from the other parallels.
There were things I had to consider. Of course, we couldn't get confused. Which world are we in? And so, in terms of grading, in terms of colour, in terms of light, they had to look different, they had to feel different, yet at the same time, I wanted the film to have a cohesive look.
A story is a journey in understanding the message that the storytellers want to convey. I like to think that storytelling, with any method, linear or non-linear, is a way of delivering that message. Pieces of mosaic that come together, introducing us to these new worlds and taking us on this journey of narratives and discovery.
Despite knowing the journey, and where it leads, I embrace it.